Hi, I'm David Barella, and today I want to take you through how I've set up a DevOps pipeline for Ethereum development by using a combination of Truffle and Visual Studio Team Services. Now, I did do a blog post on how to do this about a year ago, but it was very convoluted and clunky, and that was just because of the limitations of the technology at the time. Now, there have been a number of improvements since I last did it. Truffle is much easier and simpler to install now. NPM has a cool new command, and Visual Studio Team Services now supports hosted Linux build agents, which means I don't have to set up a virtual machine anymore. I can just use their throwaway ones. Now, all of the steps I have here should work on any build system, such as Jenkins or Team City. But what I'm going to show today is how to do this on Visual Studio Team Services, because that's what I'm most familiar with. Now, to do this, it happens in three main steps. The first one is configuring NPM to go install on some packages that we need. The second one is to configure our Truffle JS to get it ready for the build agent for a remote server to build this for us. And then finally, we're going to set up our build server by setting up the tasks that we want it to do. There's only four or five simple tasks there. Now, if you get lost and or you just want to have something for your build agent to point at so that you can just test this out yourself, I've actually created a sample repo up on GitHub. So if you clone that, and then get your build agent to point to your clone, then you should be able to just get started. Now, let's start at the beginning. I'm going to create a new Truffle project, so DevOps demo, empty folder, Truffle init, and it's just going to create a simple Truffle project for us. So go code dot, that's going to launch Visual Studio Code for us with the context of that folder, and we can see it's standard. We've got our contracts and we've got this Truffle JS. So let's start at the beginning. It says check if you have a packages.json file. Now we don't have one. So we need to create one, and we can do that with npm init. And WordPress is trying to be helpful, so that's getting in the way. Okay. Npm init. Great. And if we have a look, that created just a standard template. Now let's run that next command, and if WordPress would stop being useful. Stop at WordPress. Copy. Let's actually test that. NPM install. Yep, it's all there. WordPress. Now, if we let that go, what that is actually doing is going and installing as a dev dependency all of these tools, so then our build server can go and use these tools. Now, the problem that I had before is we'd have to install these things on globally because these would take a long, long time to install. And so I'd have to set up a virtual machine with these pre-installed. Now, because the Truffle have gone and made these things a lot simpler to install and it takes a lot less time, we can just go install these as dev dependencies. Then on our build server, when it goes and does this restore, now we've got these tools that we can run within this project, and we don't have to have them installed globally anymore. And so that makes that much, much simpler. So we'll let that go. And so what we're installing is Truffle, so we can do that build and compile and the testing to do test RPC so that we can have a little in-memory blockchain that we can test against. Mocha to run our unit tests, and then this JUnit reporter so that we can spit out the XML file of our test results. So we need those four things, and that's going to take a few more seconds. We'll just let that finish, and while that's finishing, let's have a look at what we would want to do next. Now, the next step is we have to update our Truffle JS so that we can do two things. Well, there we go. Well, let's have a look at that first. If we go and look at our packages.json, now we see our dev dependencies. We've got those four things there. So that's great. Now, if we go back to here, I can get back to this Truffle.js file. We're doing two main things. One, we're adding in a new network definition so that we can tell Truffle to go and test against this network or do migration against this network. And the cool little hack here is we're going test RPC provider, which means that Truffle will go and spin up a new test RPC instance just for the lifetime of that command. So Truffle test or Truffle migrate. And once that command finishes, it will go and just throw it away again. So that's great for our build server because we don't need to install test RPC globally anymore. We don't need to spin it up before we run our tests. We don't have to worry about tearing it down after our tests finish because this will just happen automatically and only live for the life of the context of that one command. And the second thing is we're just going to put in some definition for mocker. So this is getting it ready for our build agent. We're going to leave it as the spec reporter so that when the developer runs it locally, we can still see the results. But we're going to go and just predefine what the output file will be so it's ready for our build server. Now let's just copy these bits one at a time. Truffle.js. We'll go and put that test RPC definition up the top. We will add in a new network. A bit too much. Okay, so we've got that new network, and so after networks, we're going to add this section for mocker. Great, that all looks good. Now let's make sure that I haven't broken anything. So if we go truffle test dash dash network, and use the name of that network that I had here, local test, hit run. Now that will go have Truffle compile all of our contracts. Then it's going to try to connect to our local test network, which here means it will go and spin up our test RPC in memory network temporarily. And then it will go and run all the tests. So in a second, we should see the test start executing. There we go, and all the tests. And because we've still left the spec reporter here, they'll go and output here so our developer can keep on running our test here locally. Now, let's move on to, so we've got this ready. Let's go and have our build server build this. Now, if I go and create C source demo, we'll call it a DevOps demo. DevOps demo. And let's set a default for node for the git ignore. Have a look at our changes. Yep, that's all the files that we want. Have a look at our Truffle.js. Yep, that's what we want. Package.json. There's our dev dependency. Okay, it all looks good. So we'll call this the initial check-in, commit it to master, and we just publish that up to GitHub, publish. Okay, now I've gone and pushed my code up to GitHub, ready for us to do it. Now for the building of it, now Microsoft, there's a cool thing called Visual Studio Team Services. And you can go and sign up for a free account for this. And if you sign up for a free account, you can go and host your code up on here if you want. I'm not doing that today, because as you see, I'm using GitHub to post the code. But what they do let you do with free accounts, you get 240 minutes of build time for free. And so we're going to be using this to build our code. And these builds only take 1 to 2 minutes. And so that's for 240 minutes for free, we get a whole bunch of builds out of it. Now, once you go and sign up for a free account, you'll be in your projects folder. So if I create a new project, let's call this DevOps demo. Now, we can get it to host the source code for us, but I'm using GitHub, so it doesn't matter what we choose there. I only want to share with team members. That'll take a couple seconds to create. move that there. Let's move this over here so that I can look at these things as I'm going through. Okay, now it's set that up. We're going to go to build and release, go to builds, and it's going to tell us that we don't have a build definition yet. So we're going to create a new definition. And there are a whole bunch of defaults here. So if you're building iOS applications or Android applications or web apps or Node.js projects, but we're just going to create a new empty process. Now it wants us to set it up. This one is important. It asks us what type of build agent do we want to build this. Now I'm going to use hosted Linux preview. This means Microsoft hosts this for us. They'll just go and spin up a Linux build agent for us, do the build, and then throw stuff away for it. If we go to get sources, if I clicked this project, if I was using the Git repository within Visual Studio Team Services, I could use that. But because I'm using the one on GitHub, we're going to set this up. So if I authorize, there we go. And we give it a second for it to go and pull down all of the repositories that I have access to, which is quite a few, so it may take a couple seconds. There we go. If I scroll down to David Barella, and what do I call this? DevOps demo. Master branch. Great. And one other cool thing, if we go over to triggers, and we can turn on continuous integration. So every time I go and change my Solidity smart contracts and do a push, then this is going to automatically detect that new code has been pushed to GitHub, pull down that source code for you, and then start doing the build. So if we go over to tasks, we can now start setting them all up. And if we have a look, the first one is to do that npm install. So we'll go and restore all of those node modules for us. If we have a look at it, it's just standard npm install. Next one is a shell script. If we add in that shell script, change this to version 3 so I can get this inline bit, and now I can just copy this. That looks good. We can give this a name. What do I call this? There we go. Scroll down. We want to add in another shell script. Version 3, so I can get that inline again. That looks good. What do I call this? Truffle commands. And the last step, which is to just simply publish those test results. Okay, now that's it. Let's have a quick overview of what's here. So again, that npm install is going to just restore all of our dev dependencies so that we can execute those commands. This environment details and config is just here as an informational thing. I like having it so that if things break, I can see what version of Node the build agent had, the npm version, and the version of Truffle. Now, once that's spat out, what we do is we do a string replace inside of that truffle.js file so that it will change it from that spec reporter over to our Mocha JUnit reporter. Yeah, that's what I thought. WordPress didn't copy the entire line for me. That would have been bad. And then after that, we go and do all those truffle commands. Now, this npx command is really cool. What it does is it will first check if you've got, we'll go and run this command if you have it inside the node modules folder. Now, because we have it as a dev dependency and we've installed it, if we go npx truffle, it will go look in that the node modules folder, see that truffle is there, and then just execute it. So this is how we don't need to install things globally anymore. So we compile them, I go and test that our migration scripts are all correct. So then we push them out to that test RPC. That gets blown away before we do our next thing, which is doing an MPX truffle test, again against that local test network. And then we'll go do run all our unit tests. Now, I could probably just run that one command and it will do those above two, but I like being explicit. Just so if something breaks, I can track down where it broke. And the final step is just to take search for any test XML output files and then just publish those test results. So let's save and queue this, and everything should be working well. Queue. Build 94 has been queued. And let's go watch it while it's doing it. Now, crossing our fingers, everything has worked well. If not, we'll just go back and try to debug it a bit. Here we go. We're running. The first thing it should be doing is pulling down a source code from GitHub. It's done that. It's doing an npm install to restore all of those node packages, so Truffle, test RPC, etc. This would take a couple of seconds for it to go and pull down all those packages. Done. So it's bidding out our environment variables. So we're on node version 8, npm version 5.3, Truffle 3.4. It's now doing our Truffle compile. Yep. It's doing our Truffle migrate. Those migrations are looking good. And now it looks like it's about to run our tests. Running. Cool. It's done it. It's publishing our test results. Hey, that's looking good. Now let's go look at our tests and change the outcome to show us all unit tests, and we can see all our unit tests are here. There we go. So that took 15 minutes to go and set up a fresh brand new Truffle project, to go and get it configured, create a brand new project in Visual Studio Team Services, and get our entire build set up, configured and running. So I hope that found that useful. I tried to do it as a video as well as a blog post, so that you can see someone do it step by step. So I hope that works out for you. And if you do end up using this for any of your projects, I'd love if you left a comment and told me about it, because I'm just interested in what people are building. Thanks a lot.